Hello everybody and welcome to another Pokemon X and Y Wi-Fi battle. This time against a guy named Sir Hax, also known as HaxorKitteh. Anyway, I'm using some Pokemon, he's using lots of Pokemon that I have not seen yet in X and Y, such as Rhyperior, Zoroark, and Ninjas. I mean, I haven't seen them, someone else using them in battle, I've seen them in a game before, but... So yeah, this'll be fun. Here we go. Sir Hax, which is actually a lady, is issuing a challenge. But he's really a guy, but he picked the girl trainer because... If you pick the girl trainer, you're smarter because you have more customization options. Anyway, I start off with Obvious, and he starts off with Ninjask named Maggot. And I start off with Spikes, and he starts off with Swords Dance. And mistake number one. I know what Ninjasks do. I used to use one named Gorast. I should have started off with a Play Rough. I should have tried to kill this thing. But... Now we're just going to keep substituting, and I'm just going to keep breaking the substitutes with Play Rough. So honestly, let's just speed through this part, because that's all it's going to be until he can't make any more substitutes. Alright, now he goes for Baton Pass. I think he could have made one or two more substitutes, but I guess he was getting impatient. So yeah, he passes all this to Fuddlepoo, the Rhyperior. Great. Well, I still went for Play Rough because that was still the same turn. So, now I go for Reflect, hoping to not die. But let's be honest here, he passed a Swords Dance and it's an Earthquake. Yeah, Oathkeeper's not going to survive that. But, now that the Reflect is up, the next person should be able to do fine. I send out Camellia, because super effective. But, by frisking it, I learned it has a weakness policy. But honestly, I'm not going to not use Hornleech just because it has a weakness policy. But, basically, if you don't know, weakness policy is a new item where, if you're hit with a super effective attack, it sharply boosts your attack stats. So he gets another attack boost from that. But yeah, another thing I should mention is using Poison Jab. Either, again, someone seems to think Poison is good against Camellia, or it's only one move he has that he's real, that is, I don't know, somewhat good against Trevenant. Because his other move was clear Earthquake, another one is probably Stone Edge, and I don't know what his fourth move could have been, but honestly, they were probably all not as good. That's probably why he was using Poison Jab. But anyway, yeah, I'm able to take down his Rhyperior, but Camellia is almost dead. Now, he sends out Lil Johnny, the Gengar. But watch this. It steps on Spikes. I'm like, no, that is not Gengar, that's Zoroark, but it doesn't matter. I have nothing. I guess I was thinking there's nothing I feel comfortable switching into. So I just let Camellia die. Rewatching this, I'm not sure if that was the best idea, but I guess that was my logic behind it. Now I go for an Air Slash, another weird move. I feel like, look at that, if I had gone for Draco Meteor, I would have killed Zoroark right there. But no, for some reason I thought Air Slash would have been better. So, yeah, that's a thing. He got an attack off on me, and now he switches off to Maggot, again, as Death Fodder, which is understandable because, yeah, there's nothing more ninjas can do anyway. So that goes down. And in comes Pregniscon. Alright, Mega Kangaskhan time. Overused and overrated. I know exactly what it's going to do. It's going to fake out. So, let's go out to Sidious. Because he can, he's Ghost. Normal won't hurt it. And he's going to Mega Evolve. And the baby is alive. And yes, Obvious fake out is Obvious. And it misses. And Obvious Sucker Punch is Obvious. Confuse Ray. Oh, I felt so evil right here. I got up a Confuse Ray on it. And then he's going to try to use another Sucker Punch. But he's going to hit itself twice. I'm just kidding. It doesn't hit itself twice. But it hits itself one. It hits itself. I use Sludge Bomb, which almost kills it. He's still confused. And he hits himself again. Yes. Let the hate flow through you. Because I'm using Sidious. It makes sense. Anyway, so I kill his Mega Kangaskhan epically. He's on his own Gengar. And he uses Substitute. Clearly, his Gengar is faster. He probably has a timid nature Gengar. Mine's modest. So, yeah. That's probably why he's faster. Either that or he wins the speed tie twice in a row. But for some reason, I don't think to switch here. Again, I guess I'm thinking I have nothing to take the hit. So I guess I just let Sidious die? Again, I feel like that wasn't a good idea, but I don't... Whatever. I don't know what I was thinking. But in comes Garchomp, and here's why I lose this battle. I, for some reason, am predicting him to switch out. So I go for... Guess what move? Iron Head. Now, here's my logic. I was going to go for Dragon Claw, but I was thinking he has Azumarill on his team. I was thinking he might want to switch out to Azumarill because, you know, Fairy beats Dragon. But, so I went for an Iron Head because, you know, and my other thought was Earthquake, but he has Gengar. Earthquake won't even hurt Gengar. So, yeah. And he went first the second turn because the speed drop had taken into effect after I had Mega Evolved. So, yeah. That is why I lost the battle right there. Over prediction. I didn't think Gengar would have an attack that would be good against Garchomp, but yeah, he had Dazzling Gleam, so he had no reason to switch out to Azumarill. But that's what I was expecting him to do, switch out. So, because of that, his Gengar ends up killing my Garchomp. So, yeah, I send out Noivern, Vanstrom, use Air Slash, which does quite a lot, so I'm very happy about that. But I'm obviously not going to survive a Play Rough, because even if I had full health, I wouldn't have survived that. So, then I sent out Mop, my last Pokemon. And here's the battle where I learned, I think I should give Mop Thunderbolt. Why doesn't Mop have Thunderbolt, do you ask? Because he's a bulky Starmie. His moveset is Scald, Ice Beam, Rapid Spin, and Recover. I'm very highly considering replacing Recover with Thunderbolt, because watching all my past battles, I've never used Recover. But anyway, he misses Play Rough, and I'm like, wow, are you kidding me? Do I actually have a chance now at winning because of a miss? Fine, I'll take it. So he's another Scald, and I do end up taking out his Azumarill. But if earlier I had used Draco Meteor on his Zoroark, he would not have his Zoroark to send out right now. Right now, yeah. And Zoroark proceeds to finish me off, as you will soon see. Because the spikes were not enough to kill him. And according to him, I think he had like somewhere between 1 and 3 HP left at that point. So he was like, wow, I can't believe I survived that. So, my two big mistakes during that battle were not using Draco Meteor on Zoroark and over-predicting the switch out with his Gengar. So, honestly, yeah, that was a really fun battle, though. It really kept me on my feet. And something I really should mention now, a lot of you are probably thinking, hey, Alkablade, why are you posting so many losses? Back in your old days, you would win almost every battle. But this time, it seems like you're losing more than winning. Well, my good sir, I only post battles that I find are good. What by good I mean are ones that were a lot of fun to do and I feel like are entertaining to watch. Usually, when a battle was not good, it's because I swept my opponent without any, I don't know, without much challenge. I'm not uploading those battles, unlike PBR, where I upload every single battle I did. That's why there were so many more wins in PBR, whereas this, so far I have more losses. Because, again, I only upload battles that I think were very fun to do, and I think are entertaining if I was to make a video of it. So yeah, I've definitely had one loss that I thought was not a fun loss to upload. So it's not like I'm only the one crushing my opponents and that's making the battle bad. There's definitely been one battle where I'm thinking of where I got completely swept by a Barbaracle who shell smashed a couple times and I had nothing to resist it. And I didn't think that was a very fun battle because it was just a Barbaracle sweeping my whole team. So yeah, that is why most of these battles I'm uploading are losses, because words. I've explained it like 3 times now. Regardless, I hope you enjoyed this battle. This battle was very fun to me, and I hope you look forward to more Wi-Fi battles and or other videos I happen to make. Thank you again for watching, and of course, rock on.